4 days, he would vote yes. But if it's 30 days, he says he's going to vote no. Rand Paul says he's going to vote no, too.
Well, there's all kinds of legitimate reasons to be against these short-term continuing resolutions. I mean, this is a completely dysfunctional, broken appropriation process. But now we are in this facing this reality, and I don't like playing shutdown politics. I don't like playing this gamesmanship.
There's a relatively simple way of guaranteeing not just 60, but 70, maybe 80 votes in the Senate if you attach what Lindsey Graham, Dick Durbin have put forward, a compromise that would allow hundreds of thousands of Dreamers to remain in the United States.
Well, I'm not sure that plan would pass the Senate, and I doubt it. I know it wouldn't pass
Democrats
the House.
Democrats would vote for it.
Wouldn't pass the House. So you know, what
a
we need
a lot of Democrats in the House of Representatives. Let me just correct you, because a lot of Democrats in the House would vote for it if the Dreamer part, if there was an amendment including allowing the Dreamers to stay. And of course, a lot of Republicans would vote for it as well. So it would pass the House, it would pass the Senate if you guys decided, let's do what this bipartisan group wants to do and just end the whole Dreamer controversy right now and attach that legislation to the bill.
And I think the vast majority just want to fix the problem with the
Dreamers to stay.
Absolutely.
So what's the big deal?
So what we also want to is we want to secure our border, which for decades,
it's
multiple administrations, we haven't done that.
Lindsey Graham says it's part of the arrangement.
But it's not an adequate part.
It doesn't include everything. He says down the road, you have to have comprehensive immigration.
And Wolf, not even close.
Greater border security, other issues. But right now, short term, you strengthen border security and you allow the Dreamers to stay.
Barely strengthen it. And you could barely ever start building it. Again, there's a lot of caveats, a lot of...
But you need a compromise in order to keep the government from shutting down.
I know. A compromise is always do everything the Democrats want and give Republicans a crumb. And unfortunately, I think that's what that bipartisan bill was.
If the government shuts down, you understand what that means for the millions and millions of American people. They're not going to get the services of the federal government.
Well, so the clean bill is by and large just let's keep the government operating while we, in good faith, sit down and talk about how we can handle the problem with the Dreamers, as well as secure our border, improve, correct our legal immigration system. I mean, it's a completely broken, dysfunctional system. Wolf, we let
Lindsey Graham says he wants to deal with that. He wants comprehensive immigration reform, but he understands you can't do everything right now. The president, in that earlier meeting last week, he said, bring me a compromise. I will support it. It will be a bill of love, and let me take the heat. He changed his mind 2 days later.
Again, you have to look at that particular deal. It was just completely inadequate. The president knew it was inadequate. I think most of us members who have taken a look at that deal, it just doesn't really satisfy the border security, ending diversity lottery, I mean, really ending it, limiting the family migration, which has been a big problem. Wolf, we let
there will be some steps in this legislation that Lindsey Graham and Dick Durbin have put forward.
Very
but
minor.
It's not going to do everything.
Minimal.
But isn't it worth it to keep the government from shutting down?
That shouldn't be part of the equation here. Let's just keep the government opening. Open.
But you're not going to get 60 votes unless you do it.
Again, the vast majority of Republicans will vote to keep the government open, fund the military, to make sure
that you need Democrats.
Well, hopefully the cooler heads will prevail.
They say they're not going to do it. Listen to Chuck Schumer.
Well, then we'll keep
the other Democrats.
Then we'll keep voting over and over again.
Are you concerned, though, that the American public will blame the leadership in the Senate, the leadership in the House, the leadership in the White House, all Republicans, for a government shutdown?
Well, first of all, we do have majority in the Senate, but we don't control it. These types of bills, we need Democrat support. So the American people have to take a look at who voted to keep the government open. How many Republicans voted to keep it open? How many Democrats? And I think it should be a pretty simple evaluation. If very few Democrats vote to keep the government open,